Paldies.
Man ļoti patīk jāaugstās durvītes, augstā griestiņā.
Beidzot, tu normāli muzīkas atas klausīties. Mēs esam versatāli. Daudz muzīkas.
Paldies, tu!
Did you see the pools and everything?
It's nice. Hey, the restaurants, the gyms, the mechanic lab.
Because I was asking Chris today, I was like, do you feel like this is going to be the right place? And he was like, yeah. So I guess it will be. Going to practice, 8:30 in the morning, more or less. Another day of work. Simple. Turn up the music, get the juices going, and let's get to work. Next couple of months, I'm going to be here in Madrid, coming here at the Real Madrid facility. They allowed us to come here and use their stuff and for the rehab.
So. Por lo menos tiene un color más agresivo, Guillo.
No, bonito, Guillo. Este no tiene color.
Es tuyo, Guillo. Ya. Cosa. Mira. Perdona, Guillo, que tiene otra vez, tío.
Cuatro. Cinco.
I chose Madrid because I was looking at different options and this one was the best for me because of their facilities, obviously, and just overall, you know, what they have available here is one of the top, you know, in the world.
Valdi and him speak Spanish and they feel very comfortable in Spain. They have been there before. Valdi knows all the specialists there and so on. So he can actually bounce some ideas off, and the physiotherapists also that work in a Real Madrid facility, which he, you know, in a certain way is a help to him. Plus, the facility is very, very impressive. You know, the facility is built for the best, basically for the best in Europe, for football and basketball.
Slower, 4, 5, 6, and 10, hold it up, 7, 8, 9, 10, good, hold it up, resist, I'm gonna push, good, Chris, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
so this is the part that doesn't fire on you, Chris, that's why this will work. So this works, those two need to get better.
Reach your right arm up, right? That's gonna give you more balance. Good, there you go. It's your right hand center. Good, there you go. What happens is this works, right? Uh-huh. And then this holds on, and then this works a lot, uh-huh. But then it comes all the way back up to here. Uh-huh. So what you're gonna have to do is shoot straight up, right? So you're going to have to use your ass straight, no? Mm-hmm. How you get that little extra push is this. Pull. Right, so we're gonna pull this side, we're gonna push this side. Mm-hmm. Good.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good. 1, 2. Make it. Chris's movement is very unique, not only because of his size, but also because of his skill. There hasn't been anybody, especially in the NBA or anywhere, that can actually move that well at that size. So he actually looks like a smaller player until you see him up close, which actually translates to the court. Main goal with Chris is to be able to teach him how to use his natural leverage, because his skills are actually more like a small forward. But teaching his leverage, his center of gravity, his opportunities to use both sides of both feet equally, because he's so explosive, either off one leg or both. And we just want to kind of recapture that that happened before the injury.
At some moments, training is boring and it's same thing over and over again, and you just keep working on the strength of your leg and you keep doing these drills that without the injury would be probably really easy. But this injury is also mental, and that's the main part for me, to stay fresh mentally, to stay hungry every morning, to wake up and go after it and try to work on that leg. At this moment, I am almost 4 months out of the surgery, getting some shots up in the gym, which I already started pretty early. But I'm moving my feet now, I'm jumping just a little bit, and I'm not allowed to run yet. We're really taking our time with that, making sure the muscles are back to normal. Before we start running, we're also doing the walking part, which we did today earlier. We walked for an hour straight in a pretty good pace. Obviously doing upper body, lifting weights. We're not too obsessed with that. We don't want to put on too much weight on a knee coming out of a surgery. So the main thing is working on my overall body, on my biomechanics, on just building up my whole body, that it's compact and I'm strong when I come back. And also, obviously, I want to come back and feel the same athletically as I did before the injury, or even better. I'm healing really, really fast, and we're doing all the right things to make sure we don't rush anything, take our time. And you know, it's been really, really smooth so far, and we want to keep it that way.
He heals fast because of his preparation, because of his routine, because of his habits, because of his diet, hydration. He's just so detail-oriented. He doesn't miss really anything. And for somebody that's that young, it's really, really important, because we can take advantage of his youth and his ability to heal. But he has kind of the sense of urgency of a veteran that's going after his last contract. So, but the rehab's, I believe, is going really well. And I believe he's gonna come back just a different monster. I mean, he was hard to deal with before, but I believe he's gonna be much, much harder to deal with after.